Hello students, in this experiment we measure the equipotential lines and the electric field created by a variety of electrodes. The first configuration consists of two point charges. One charge is negative and another charge is positive. The separation between them is 11 cm. Equivalent to 11 spaces in water bath. The potential across them is 10 volts. To test the equipotential line, touch the back wire of voltmeter at negative electrode. Immerse the red wire into the water. Let's say the point A, the potential is 4 volts. Now we get one data point of 4 volts. Repeat the same procedure by touching the back wire at negative electrode. Immerse the red wire into the water at other position. Suppose the point B here also has 4 volt potential. Let's get one more data point. Touch the back wire at negative electrode where the potential is 0. Touch the red wire at the other position. The point C also shares the 4 volt potential. Now we have sufficient data points to draw a smooth line connecting all three data points. This curve is the shape of 4 volt equipotential lines. Next, we study the equipotential line which has a different potential, let's say at 5 volt. The 5 volt equipotential line is at the middle. Finally, we may study the equipotential line at 6 volt. The 6 volt equipotential line is close to the positive electrode. What we say so far is the instruction of the equipotential line measurement. Now we move on to measure the electric field. Tie together the back and red wire of voltmeter by a rubber band. Choose the initial point close to the negative electrode and deviate it into the upper half or the lower half. For example, we choose the point A as an initial point. Touch the back wire at the point A and rotate the red wire about point A. As red wire rotate, the potential can be positive, zero, or negative. Find the position on the circumference at which the potential is maximum. Let's say at point B. Move the back wire from point A to replace the red wire at point B. Now rotate the red wire about point B. Find the new position of red wire where potential is maximum. Repeat the same procedure, we get more data points until crossing to the positive electrode. Draw a smooth line connecting all data points. This curve gives the orientation of electric field. Draw many arrows tangent to the curve from high voltage to low voltage. Now we obtain both equipotential line and electric field created by a pair of positive and negative point charges. Next, for the second configuration, change either positive or negative charge from a point to a pair. For example, the positive charge is now a pair. Repeat the same procedure to measure the equipotential line and electric field in the case of combination of a positive pair and negative point. Now we are performing a simple demonstration to visualize the electric field. To see whether its shape is in accordance with the theoretical expectation or not, here we have one positive pair and one negative point. We apply the sufficiently high voltage about 3.5 kV. At such a high voltage, we no longer use the water because it can be short circuit. We have to use vegetable oil as liquid. Sprinkle many seeds on the oil surface. They arrange themselves along the orientation of electric field. They wonderfully form a pattern in good agreement with the electric field. Let's examine the pattern closely. The electric field first goes straight from a pad and later bends toward a point. At the middle of the pad corresponding to the position of the point, the electric field goes straight directly to a point without changing its direction at all. The electric field on the left side is symmetric to that on the right side, namely, the electric field first goes straight from a pad and then bends toward a point.Next, we move on to the actual experiment that we record data in our report. Here we have one positive point and one negative point. Connect the wire from positive and negative point to the positive and negative polarity of a power supply. Apply 10 volts across two point charges. For the first activity, touch the back wire at negative point where the potential is zero. We measure the potential at every 2 cm.The voltmeter shows 4.53 volts. Record the measured potential in a table. Move further 2 cm, the potential is 5.24 volts. We keep going to the last position. Let's see the data. The potential gradually increases as moving from negative point to positive point. The first position closest to negative point is 4.53 volts and the last position closest to the positive point is 7.62 volts.In the second activity, the configuration is still to oppositely charged point. First tower we study and equip potential line. For example, at 4 volts, immerse the red wire into the water. This position has potential roughly 3 volts. Move the red wire under the water until we find the position at which the potential is 4 volts. Record this 4 volt position in a graph.Next, we move the red wire in the lower half to find the second position of 4 volts. Here, the monitor shows 4.22 volts as moving toward negative point, the potential decreases. Keep moving in this direction. We will finally find the second 4 volt position. Record it in a graph. Next, we move to the red wire in the upper half to find the third 4 volt position.Once we have three data points, draw a smooth line connecting them. This curve shows the shape of 4 volt equipotential line. Repeat the same procedure to trace the equipotential line at higher voltage, for example at 6 volts. Once we have three data points, draw a smooth line connecting them. This curve shows the shape of 6 volt equipotential line. Repeat the same procedure to trace the 7 volt equipotential line. Again,When we have three data points, draw a smooth line connecting them, show the shape of the 7 volt equipotential line. We finish three equipotential lines at 4, 6, and 7 volts. Next, we study the pattern of electric field. Use a rubber band to tie the black and red wire together. Choose the initial position in the vicinity of negative point, for example, 2 cm in horizontal direction.From the negative point, followed by 2 cm in vertical direction. The potential between back and red wire is much less than 1 volt. The voltmeter automatically changes the unit from volt to millivolt. Now the potential is just about 200 millivolt. We rotate the red wire around the back wire until we find the position at which the potential is maximum. The potential changes.228, 229, 231, 232, 233, 234, still keep rising to 235 millivolt. If we rotate the red wire further, the potential decreases. The maximum voltage is about 235 volt. Record the position of red wire where 235 millivolt appear in a graph.The maximum point is this point. The previous point is the initial point. Next, we move the back wire from the initial point to replace the red wire at the maximum position. Let's see how to do in the water bath. Rotate the red wire about the back wire to find the next maximum point. Repeat the same procedure. We get more data point until crossing over the positive point.Draw a smooth line connecting all the data points. This curve represents the electric field pointing from high potential to low potential. So we draw many arrows along this curve. The physical meaning of each arrow is if we are at this point, the electric field here is shown by this arrow pointing slightly downward. If we are at the middle, the electric field represented by other arrow point horizontally. Or if we are close to the negative point, the electric field is represented by this arrow. Now we finish the second activity. Let's move on to the third activity. We change one of the charge points, either positive or negative, to a pair. For example, let's change the negative point to the negative pair. The other electrode remains a positive point. First of all, we study the equipotential line. We choose the position of the first equipotential line so close to the negative pair. That its shape adjusts itself to look like a pair. For example, we choose the first equipotential line to be at 1.6 volt with back wire touching the negative pair. We move the red wire in the water to find a position at which the potential is 1.6 volt. We record the 1.6 volt position in the gap. Now we get one data point here. Repeat the same procedure to find two more data points. We get one data point in the upper half and other point in the lower half. Once we have three data points, draw a smooth line connecting them. This perfectly straight line is the 1.6 volt equipotential line. Generally, whatever the shape of electrode is, the equipotential line very close to the electrode. Adjust its shape look like the shape of electrode. Next, trace the equipotential line at higher voltage, for example 3 volt. We find three data points at which the potential is 3 volt, one data point at the center, the other in the upper and lower half. Draw a smooth line connecting data point. This curve is the 3 volt equipotential line. Proceed similarly, we trace the 5.5 equipotential line. We find three data points at 5.5 volt, one data point at the center, the other in the lower half, and the last one in the upper half. Draw a smooth line connecting them, we get 5.5 volt equipotential line. Next, we study the electric field. Remove the back wire from a negative pair. Tie the back wire with the red wire with rubber band. Choose the initial point in the vicinity of negative pair. For example, go 3 cm to the right, then follow by 3 cm below. Let's see in the water bath, 1, 2, 3, go downward, 1, 2, 3, back wire touch the initial point, rotate the red wire about the back wire to find the position at which the potential is maximum. We rotate counterclockwise or clockwise, both directions make potential smaller. This means the maximum position should be in horizontal direction. We get the maximum position here. The first position is our initial point. Move the back wire from the initial point to replace the red wire here. Let's say in the water bath. Repeat the same procedure to find the next position where potential is maximum. Let's say in the graph. Keep going until we obtain enough data points. Near the negative pair, the electric field aligns horizontally. As passing the middle of the water bath, the electric field bends considerably toward the positive point. Draw a smooth line connecting all the data points. And draw many arrows pointing from high voltage to low voltage. In other words, pointing from positivity to negativity, as we said before, if we are here close to the positive point, the electric field is shown by this arrow. It's pointed diagonally downward. If we are here, the electric field is shown by this arrow. Its direction is simply horizontal.